So it says this, we're going to jump to Daniel 2:44. It says, in the days of these kings, the God of heaven shall set up a kingdom. Okay, not a new religion, not a new temple religion, a kingdom which shall never be destroyed. So in other words, once this kingdom is inaugurated, arrives, it will never be destroyed. And the kingdom shall not be left to another people. So the sons of God are the stewards of this kingdom forever. But it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms. And in context in Daniel, Daniel has seen visions of different kingdoms. And the prophecy of the word of the Lord coming to Daniel is that the kingdom that's coming, the kingdom that cannot be shaken, the kingdom that cannot be destroyed, will consume all other kingdoms. What kingdoms are they? These are the kingdoms of this world. And it will break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. So now we're starting to get a picture of the government of God, what it looks like. It is a kingdom led by a king and carried out on, initially carried on the shoulders of the King Jesus, that through his death, burial, and resurrection and ascension, and when the Spirit comes, a new race of heavenly people are born into the earth, that whose job is to advance this kingdom. And the kind of people that advance this kingdom are those disciples who mature into the fullness of Christ. That is the standard. That is the disciple-making process until we reach the measure of the stature of his fullness, the fullness of his authority, the fullness of his abilities, the fullness of his nature. This is the job of the, what we talked about, the fivefold ministry last week. So the kingdom of God is prophesied to consume all other kingdoms and break them to pieces. The only kingdom to remain is the kingdom of God. So the only kingdom to remain on this earth is God's kingdom. And when we started talking about this, I was using the example of the book of Luke when he sent out the 70. He sent out the 70, and he expected the 70 to heal the sick in every city. And before Jesus leaves the earth, he said, go into every nation and make disciples. So he expects us to disciple or consume nations. So the job of the ecclesia, the job of the kingdom is to take dominion by consuming all other kingdoms. So we're going to consume the works of the devil's kingdom. We're going to consume death. We're going to consume sickness. We're going to consume disease. We're going to consume poverty. We're going to consume all of these things that stem from death that enter the world because of the devil. And then we're going to consume nations. We're going to consume literal kingdoms of the earth by what? Making disciples. We're going to go in and see them be reborn by the Spirit as disciples, whole nations discipled, consumed by the kingdom. So if you can kind of start to get this picture from beginning to end, which is really the point of this and talking about dominion, we have to go back to the very beginning and see that God's purpose for man was dominion. That is the purpose for man. And then we see God restore man back to the place and the position that the first Adam had. But then we see him restore man even further, which is the point of Jesus, unto likeness to God. And so if we reverse engineer and we see that the kingdoms of this world became the kingdoms of our Lord and Christ, we can reverse engineer that and go, that is going to happen. The word of God is true and it will happen. And so we need to take a look at what we're doing and say, is what we're doing in the kingdom, in the ecclesia, as a disciple, is what I'm doing lining up with that end goal, right? If a country steals the secrets to an airplane from another country, and it's the most technologically advanced airplane, and that country is, you know, a third world country, and they have not developed their technology, they can now steal this plane or steal the blueprints and reverse engineer the technology to arrive at the blueprint. And this is what God's done here. He has sent the blueprint, Jesus, with a government on his shoulders that is destined to consume all the kingdoms of this world, including the kingdom of the devil, the kingdom of hell and the nations of the world unto even the place where it says until Christ will be seated on his throne, until all of his enemies are made his footstool. You know, it's not just the devil that is the enemy of God. It is, the race of Adam, who death entered the world through, and death was passed down to their entire race. That race of Adam is an enemy of God. In fact, if your mind is not renewed to the mind of Christ and you have a carnal mind, the Bible even declares that you are an enemy of God. So all of God's enemies be put under his feet, okay? All of the world consumed, all kingdoms consumed by the kingdom of God, okay? Nowhere in here are we talking about, you know, praying a prayer to go to heaven when you die, having a good family, a 401k. Everything bows down to I'm trying to think of the best word here. Everything bows down to the immediacy and the urgency of the kingdom of God consuming the kingdoms of this world. And if your life does not line up to this, then you're on the wrong path, because Jesus, this is what following the commands of Jesus, doing the commands of Jesus, leads to this very thing.